Hello, my name is Scott for SRB Gaming. We're back here in Fallout 4, and we are here in the Institute, and I won't bother doing a recap of where we've been, but we've been to Bioscience.
Father has done remarkable things. I would not exist were it not for him.
Yeah, about that. We've been to Robotics, we've been to Bioscience. Now, I'm going to go to Advanced Systems.
Scanning unknown identity. Clearance confirmed. Greetings, sir.
All right. As you were. Institute Advanced Systems.
She's been at it for over 2 hours. What is she even testing?
Nothing. At this point, she's just doing it for fun.
I wish I had more time to spend with Quentin, but I can't be in two places at once. We haven't been able to crack that one yet.
Okay.
Well, that was productive. If you ask me, we're only scratching the surface with the latest synths.
All right. Synth relay grenade. I guess this is their firing room.
In case anyone didn't mention it, quiet time runs from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Excuse me, Doctor.
Since you're new here, you should take time to learn our safety procedures, and the sooner the better. Rules create order, and order promotes efficiency.
Okay.
How many rules are we talking about here?
Not nearly enough, if you ask me. I had some handbooks made up, but that was years ago. I'll see about getting one to you.
How big is this handbook?
Just a few thousand pages, but I like to think it's a brisk read. I certainly find it so. Take care, then.
Okay. Let's put our weapon away. Hey, we have a terminal here. View access logs. Regulation updates. Submitted to Directorate for approval. Review permissions for assigning sidearms to personnel. SRB recommendations to increase security have overridden any normal procedures for allowing Institute scientists to carry firearms. Training for said firearms also needs to be updated. Reconsider interdepartmental network access. Certain divisions appear to be abusing this. Security systems need to be reviewed by Facilities Division ASAP. Given recent events, it is extremely important that the Institute be prepared for any conceivable situation, no matter how unlikely. Dr. Io has requested this for some time, and I am now inclined to agree with him. Personal notes. I have, in the last 24 hours, observed no less than 7 blatant violations of Institute protocol. The degree to which people appear to ignore the rules, which have been put in place to keep us all safe, is incredibly disappointing. Madison insists that I continue the testing battery with the child synth. Despite my reservations about the project as a whole, if this were any other situation, I would not have second thoughts about going straight to the director. But given the circumstances, I shall simply wait it out. Was there... Yep. All right. And...
Sleep is such a waste of time. I'd rather be designing more efficient plasma emitters.
Of course. View access logs, research proposals. Human cybernetics. Build on existing Institute research into implants, cybernetics to augment human capabilities and lifespan. Previous program met with limited success in a single subject. Using a broader array of subjects and new techniques could prove highly effective. Approval. Rejected. Director. Notes. None given. Cold fusion. Divert time materials from current Phase 3 research to exploring the possibility of sustainable nuclear reactions through electrochemical processes at or near room temperatures. Pre-war work on subject yielded no concrete results. Advances in technology could potentially make it possible. Approval. No one rejected. Lee M. Notes. Evidence suggests this is and always will be a pipe dream. Miniaturization. Modification to relay assembly, allowing for extra parameters when rematerializing, specifically to explore recalibrating object size and density. Imagine if it were possible to use a relay to shrink someone down to the size of an insect, or even smaller. Approval. No one. Rejected. Watson E. Notes. Let's keep things out of the realm of science fiction, please. Plasma weaponry. Proposal. Pre-war plasma weapons exist, albeit in a somewhat primitive state. Samples have been collected with work from a dedicated research team. Said weapons could be improved upon dramatically. Approval pending. Lee M. Notes. Something to consider after phase 3 is complete. All right. And what is in here? I'm not sure if I want to go in there.
Do you know if the simulation on the main terminal has finished running?
Yes, I believe so. It should be available now.
Okay, thanks.
All right, there's just the two terminals. There's another place in here. Advanced system notes.
Oh, excuse me,
Madison
Doctor?
Lee. Ah, it's you. You're here then. Yes, yes, I know who you are. We all do. While I'm sure Father is very happy that you're here, I do hope it doesn't interrupt our work.
What is it you're
working
on?
What is it you're working on?
Advanced systems, special projects. You've seen the boy, Synth, already. We've been hard at work on him for quite a while now. Oh, before I forget, let me see that Pip-Boy of yours. I've been told to install a coarser chip in it for you. Father's orders. You're to be given full access, with the ability to relay in and out of the Institute at will.
Oh, nice. Coarser chip. What's it do?
A coarser chip? What's it do?
The same thing it does for our coursers. Creates a link to the relay that allows them, and now you, to get in and out at will. In case the significance is lost on you, you'll be the only one here with that kind of access. If nothing else, it should demonstrate the amount of trust Father has placed in you. Now, unless there's something else, I really do need to get back to work.
All right, well.
Is everything okay, Dr. Lee? You seem pretty tense.
Yes, things are... It's fine. I'm sorry. I don't socialize much. I prefer to focus on my work.
Dr. Lee. I'd like a progress report on your division, if you don't mind.
Taking your new appointment in stride, I see. Very well. We've shifted resources off of other projects, like the Child Synth, to focus on Phase 3. I'm hoping that the above-ground efforts are successful. I understand those depend heavily on you.
All right. Now, I would like to get back there, although I have this bad feeling about those lasers there. Alright, so that is Dr. Lee. Let's head out.
Oh, for goodness sake, I can't find my notes anywhere.
Hey there.
Yeah?
Alright, here's a question. Meet the division leaders.
I used to work exclusively on the Synth projects, but lately I prefer less animated pursuits. Hi there.
Hey there.
Theoretical limits are made to be broken.
Yep. Alright, synth retention.
Nothing to report, sir.
Heading over to robotics to knock some heads together.
What now?
They're dragging their feet on the targeting package upgrades I asked for.
Maybe I should take some courses with me. You know, send a message.
Please don't. There's enough friction as it is between us and pretty much all the other departments.
You going soft on me, Alana? My methods get results, and they will this time as well. You'll see.
Okay.
Sometimes you have to lean on the other departments a little to get what you need.
Doc.
So, here you are.
Justin Ayo, acting director of the Synth Retention Bureau. I'll be up front with you. We're going to be keeping a close eye on you for the near future. Despite your relation to Father, you're a bit of an unknown quantity. I'm sure you understand. There won't be any issues, will there?
Why? Don't you trust me?
I'll be honest. You're an outsider.
The first outsider to be allowed access to the Institute in quite a long time, in fact. There's little precedent for this situation, so it's only natural to take extra precautions. It's nothing personal, I assure you.
Now, Father has asked that I provide you with a brief overview of the Synth Retention Bureau. Our primary responsibility is the recovery of escaped synths that are hiding among the human population on the surface.
Why would synths want to escape?
Synths do not want. They might look like human beings, but they're machines. As to why they're escaping? That matter is currently under investigation. Our main instrument is the Courser, a third-generation synth assigned to operate on the surface. Coursers hunt down and reclaim synths that have escaped the Institute. They are highly self-sufficient, trained in combat, infiltration, and tracking. In a word, our coursers are relentless. But I gather you know all this, since you've encountered one already. In fact, I'd very much like to know how you defeated it.
I'm no
stranger to combat.
Even so, a courser should be more than a match for any single combatant. I suppose I'll have to ask robotics to perform detailed diagnostics on the entire production run. As if we don't have enough problems. Now, unless you need something else, I'll get back to work.
If you're the acting head of the SRB, who are you filling in for? Mention the coursers.
If you're the acting head of the SRB, who are you filling in for?
Dr. Zimmer holds that position. He's supervising the retrieval of some of the more high-profile units. In his absence, I keep things running smoothly.
Okay.
Dr. Ayo.
What do you want? And please, make it quick.
You mentioned that coursers undergo special training. Tell me more about it.
The SRB constantly monitors our Gen 3 synth population, looking for specific traits. Those who show tenacity, fearlessness, and independence undergo a rigorous training regimen. We teach them armed and unarmed combat, investigative techniques, psychology, and mechanical skills. Those who pass a final evaluation become coursers. The rest have their memories wiped and return to their former duties.
Justin.
Yes, what do you need?
I'd like to know more about the synth reclamation process.
Fine. Once a courser has located a rogue synth, it uses that synth's recall code to wipe its memories and render it inert. We then begin the delicate process of restoring the neural pathways to their original configuration. In those cases where the procedure is successful, the synth returns to duty with no memory of its time on the surface. All too often, we're unable to repair the damage and are forced to dispose of the unit entirely.
All right. Well. Is this the map of the Commonwealth? All right.
Good day.
Ever everyone's excited about the new Synth project.
I know it'll be a difficult adjustment for you, but try to remember that Synths aren't people.
Hey there.
I swear I spend half my time smoothing the feathers that Justin ruffles. We need to be able to collaborate with the other divisions, and that's a lot harder when they're always angry at us.
What's Justin doing that's causing friction?
Oh, he's just pushy and demanding. He thinks his problem should be everyone's biggest concern. I have to admit, though, the other divisions have never taken our needs as seriously as they should. I guess they see us as a necessary evil or something. It's really not fair. Oh, just listen to me. It's the first chance we've had to get acquainted, and all I want to do is complain. In any case, it was good to meet you.
Okay.
It's an honor to meet you, sir.
All right. And so... Oh. SRB terminal. Synth Retention Bureau Terminal 2B. Reclamation Target Tracking. Unit ID C241. Unit at large. Investigation underway. Assigned Courser X236. Location, last sighting, good neighbor. Notes, no recent sightings. Unit believed to be in railroad custody. Mem wipe likely performed by now. Unit ID S943, unit at large. Investigation suspended, see notes. Assigned courser, none. Location, last sighting, Boston Airport. Notes, investigation suspended. Area deemed too hazardous at this time. Unit ID B592, unit located, reclamation scheduled, assigned courser X688, location Libertalia Raider Stronghold. Notes, unit B592 has been mem wiped by railroad agents. New identity is Gabriel. Unit now leads Raider gang based at Libertalia. Shows highly aggressive tendencies, has killed several dozen rivals and civilians. Suspect brain damage resulting from mem wipe process. Interesting. So, Gabriel is a synth of the Libertalia. Unit ID K823 destroyed. Assigned courser X351. Location remains located northeast of Saugus Ironworks. Note, units remains discovered near Saugus Ironworks and returned to Robotics Division. Unit destroyed by multiple gunshot wounds. Suspect raiders based out of Saugus Ironworks. Unit ID L337. Unit at large. Investigation underway. Assigned courser X973. Location last sighting Corvega. Notes. Unit has been mem wiped. New identity is Leo. Exercise extreme caution. Unit has been trained by railroad and is proficient with several weapons. Unit has evaded capture twice and wounded coursers on both occasions. Really? List of informants. The following individuals have proven useful in our reclamation operations. In exchange for caps, these persons have provided information on escaped synth sightings and suspected railroad activity. If you make a new contact, add the individual to the database. The Director AO. Informant list. Cricket. Occupation, caravaneer. Location, mobile. Tommy Lonigan. Occupation, owner, proprietor, combat zone. Interesting. Trashcan Carla. Occupation, caravaneer. Location, mobile. Doc Weathers, caravaneer. AJ, chem dealer and good neighbor. Marowski, chem supplier and good neighbor. Really, Trashcan Carla is a institute. And Lucas Miller, caravaneer. He's a contact. Henry Cook, barkeep, diamonds. Really, Henry Cook. Is he the guy who runs the Colonial Tap House in the upper stands? Interesting. Well, I'll bet that. Well, let's grab some fusion cells, even though we don't really need them. synth relay grenade. All right about that.
Hello.
Hi.
Dr. Orman's lecture on cold fusion was nothing short of a revelation.
SRB terminal. Departmental notices. Our new visitor. As you know, Father has granted full access to our new visitor from the surface. That includes the entirety of the SRP. While we must accommodate Father's wishes in this matter, we must also remain diligent. Refrain from discussing any sensitive information, especially the ongoing investigation involving the Gen 3 synths. In an ideal world, the railroad will have had no influence on our new guest. We do not live in an ideal world. Missing synth investigation. Due to recent developments in our ongoing investigation into the missing synths, I am adjusting our policy regarding discussion of this subject with personnel outside of SRB. In brief, details of the investigation are now classified and cannot be shared with anyone other than SRB personnel. And even then, such conversations can take place only here in the SRB facilities. Those who are found to be in violation of this policy will face the strictest discipline. Infiltrator Unit McDonough. We found it. I'm starting to wonder if M762, the infiltrator unit, Madonna, hasn't begun to outlive its usefulness. Assuming the identity of Diamond City's mayor has provided us with invaluable intelligence over the years, but suspicions have only continued to mount. This latest incident, the publication of that newspaper article specifically calling Madonna's humanity into question, might just be the tipping point. I've spoken with Io, and we both agree. If the situation doesn't become untenable, reclamation seems unfeasible. M762 was specifically engineered to mimic the actual human McDonough. As such, the unit's synthetic biology is that of someone overweight and grossly out of shape. A mem weight would kill any psychological weaknesses attributed to self-perceived old age, but that body lost cause. The real irony here is that M762, in one of its dispatches back to the Institute, requested a future posting in the coursers, citing loyalty and years of service. And that request alone was evidence of enough self-awareness and independence to completely eliminate him from contention, never mind the fact that he wouldn't even fit into the uniform. Determination. When and if M762's identity is eventually compromised, the unit is effectively decommissioned in field. No reclamation, no institute assistance, given its relative age and physical condition, not to mention the danger inherent in an infiltrator unit's discovery. Further lifespan estimated at 2 weeks maximum. Really? McDonough is going to be dead shortly. If he's not already. It has come to my attention that certain colleagues who are dissatisfied with our policies and procedures have, on more than one occasion, tried to circumvent our established process for registering their complaints with Father, and have tried to gain access to our secure facilities in order to complain in a more direct manner. I'm sure I need not remind you that the SRB is off limits to all personnel not assigned to this division. Do not allow yourself to be browbeaten, cajoled, intimidated, or otherwise manipulated into allowing anyone who lacks the appropriate clearance to enter the SRB. Failure to uphold this mandate will result in severe discipline. Director Isle. Power conservation. As you're all aware, Father has asked that we monitor our power usage carefully and try to be as efficient as possible. As a point of personal emphasis, we should strive to be efficient in everything we do, but our division has needs that are unique among the various branches of the Institute. The fact is, sometimes our operations require resources that we cannot readily disclose due to the sensitive nature of what we do. I place my trust in your judgment. If you require additional power or any other resources to carry out your work, then take what you need. Consult me if you have any concerns or questions, but know that the responsibility of meeting your project deadlines falls upon your shoulders, and I won't accept limited power availability as an excuse for failing to meet those deadlines. In short, do what you need to do, and if anyone objects to the way in which we carry out our work, I will deal with those objections myself. Was there anything else in there? Oh, inventory management. X328 deposit, 361 count bottle caps. Requisition, 1 count rifle armament. X102, Secourt A. X102, withdraw 1,000 count bottle caps. All right.
Courses on the hunt are relentless. If you see one, you should stay out of its way.
Yep. All right, so we've been in there. Any other terminals? All right, let's return to the Institute.
Clearance confirmed.
All right. Well, meet the division leaders. Yeah, about that. Bring the serum to Virgil. Up there. All right. Have we been back here? Oh, that's right.
You get me what we talked about, and I'm in business.
All right. Let's head up here. Check this place out. Alright, so yeah, these are just habitats. Places for the scientists. Same thing in here. Bathrooms there. All right. And goes upstairs.
Hide my dad's work notes just to mess with him? It drives him crazy.
Hi there.
Watch out around here. If they catch you having fun, they make you do boring science.
All right. And this is... Okay. All right, so down there is the concourse. There are maintenance tunnels, I believe, underneath. We have several levels of quarters.
Sometimes Quentin is really mean to me, but my mom says I have to be nice anyway.
All right.
Welcome to the Institute, sir.
All systems nominal.
Report anything suspicious to the SRB.
All right.
Just as you gave life to Father, he gave life to many of us.
Yeah, about that. Alright, so where is... Alright, let's head down here. Loken, Orman. Okay. Alright, so he's on this level. Whoever we have to meet. Oh, he's going upstairs now. Is that him? Nope.
Father has done remarkable things. I would not exist were it not for him.
Oh, nope. That's who we were looking for.
It's my responsibility to make sure this place runs smoothly.
Doctor.
They weren't kidding. You really are here. Well, all right. I'm Allie. Allie Fillmore. You can think of me as the Institute's chief engineer. When Father told us about you, I could hardly believe it. You've been through so much, I think most people would have just given up. If you don't mind my asking, what was it that kept you going all that time?
What makes you ask? I'm a complete stranger to you. I guess I just wasn't ready to die. I wanted to kill...
I just wanted to find my son and keep him safe.
Now that you've found him, I hope you're proud of the great man he grew up to be. Now, I'll give you a quick rundown of the facilities division, and then I'll answer any questions you might have afterward. As you might guess, we keep the Institute's mechanical and electrical systems running smoothly. We maintain and upgrade all of the systems that make it possible to live and work in a place like this. There's a lot of machinery behind these walls that recycles the air and water and provides power to the laboratories and quarters. The work we do might not be as exciting as some of the other departments, but it's at least as important. So, now that you're here and you've spoken to Father, does that mean you're on board?
On board with what?
The Institute, of course. Sean implied you operated on a level, if not equal, then at least similar to the rest of us. Curious. If there's anything else you'd like to know about the facilities division, I'm happy to discuss it.
You can now fast travel to and from the Institute. Completed. Meet the division leaders. All right. Who built this place originally?
Who built this place originally? Has it been here long?
The construction of the Institute is the work of generations of scientists. The original survivors of the war, our progenitors, took refuge in the basement of the old Commonwealth Institute of Technology. Over time, their sons and daughters dug deeper into the earth and built increasingly sophisticated habitats and laboratories. It's a process that's still going on today. Even now, we're digging out tunnels for new facilities and infrastructure. Just think what this place will look like 100 years from now. Huh. I hope I'm there to see it.
Dr. Fillmore.
Hey, what do you need?
Tell me more.
I'd like to know about the people in your division.
Of course. Dr. Lawrence Higgs is our mechanical engineer. He oversees the major life support and security systems. Power distribution is Dr. Evan Watson's area of expertise, and Dr. Newton Oberly is in charge of food and housing. He coordinates with bioscience to ensure that our meals are balanced for optimal nutrition. We also make use of a number of Synth units for low-priority maintenance and labor.
Allie.
Hi there. Something I can help you with?
It must be a challenge to meet the power demands of a place like this.
Absolutely. We scratch and scrape for every precious ounce of voltage that we can. Over the years, we've learned a few tricks that help supplement our power budget. When necessary, we can tap into select sources on the surface. We take only what we need, of course. Fortunately,
of course.
Advanced Systems is always working on new solutions to generate more energy. It's a good thing, too, because the demand is always increasing. You don't even want to know what a single use of the molecular dematerializer consumes.
All right. Well, we have finished that mission, institutionalized, meet the division leaders. And, yeah, We have this. We can return to Virgil. We have this. Talk to Tinker Tom. This. Talk to Desdemona. And synth retention. Talk to Father. There's no summary. All right. Well, we can, if we want to, at any time, fast travel out of here. So that's what we just might do. Anyway, at this point, we've thoroughly explored the...
I have a variety of items that should prove useful in your surface missions.
Don't need to.
Dr. Watson can be a little obsessive when it comes to rules and policies.
Yeah. About that. Anyway, at this point, I think I'm going to take a break here. And we'll continue off with more Fallout 4 in the next episode. I'm thinking we will talk to Desdemona, do this, talk to Tinker Tom. And from there, well, we have a courser chip in our Pip-Boy, which allows us to come and go as we please. And if we check this, the Institute right there. Anyway, at this point, I'd like to say thank you for joining me. Thank you for watching. My name is Scott for SB Gaming. And as always, have a good day.